How's it going, guys? Good morning. It's a beautiful morning in Washington State. Today we're going to be climbing Mount St. Helens. Let's have some fun and get right to it.
In the meantime, I do have some more information from yesterday's
emergency has been declared for Skamania County and surrounding areas by the Washington Department of Emergency Services. As of 8:32 a.m. Pacific Time, reports of the volcanic eruption of Mount St. Helens have been confirmed. Hazards to residents such as pyroclastic flow and ash fall are currently happening due to the eruption. All residents within a 7-mile radius of the volcano who have not evacuated are strongly advised for your safety to shelter in place in your home until it is deemed safe. Once again, do not leave your homes until it is deemed safe, as pyroclastic flow and ashfall are currently a major threat to
your windows yet. No, not really. Get about a 40,000-foot cloud above the top of the mountain. It's entailing the entire eastern portion of the county and sky. There's quite a lightning storm going on and lots of phone calls. We understand we've also had a slide up there, but we don't know what magnitude at this time at level yet.
Reported a 5 to a 12-foot flash flood coming down from 12 miles.
Why were people up on the mountain? It's because the mountain blew so many times. Nobody believed that it would really become a disaster. Nobody believed that it could be as horrible as it is.
The president touched down in Air Force One this evening in a driving rainstorm. And if the weather doesn't clear by tomorrow, it could be difficult for him to see the devastation.
The absolute and total devastation of a region that encompasses about 150 miles. It's the worst thing I have ever seen. It is literally indescribable. And it's a devastation. There is no way to prepare oneself for the sight that we beheld this morning. I don't know that there's in recorded history in our nation that has ever been a more formidable explosion.
All the bridges, even Interstate 5, are going to be in jeopardy. This is you probably heard, this is a solid wall of logs, probably 5 or 6 to even 10 miles off. And it's just getting bigger and bigger.
Hey, what's up, guys? First of all, thank you for choosing to watch this channel. I make these videos for you guys, and I really hope you get great value out of them. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Mount St. Helens in Washington. This peak, or what's left of it, stands at a whopping 8,363 feet. Don't be fooled, though. Its extreme steepness, mixed with northwestern weather patterns, make this peak quite the formidable foe. Today's route is the challenging Worm Flows Trail from the southern end of the mountain. But before we tackle the route, let's talk parking. This route is used in the winter and spring when the climber's bivouac trailhead is closed due to snow. The nice parking lot has a visitor center and bathrooms. Many hikers even park their campers in the lot for the next day's summit attempt. Getting back to the Worm Flows Trail, this route is a whopping 10.5 miles round trip with 5,715 feet of vertical gain. It's a doozy, but it's a ton of fun. The trail begins in the very lush St. Helens Forest with mild elevation gain. It's well shaded and acts like a great warm-up for what's to come. At roughly 2 miles in, you'll begin to climb alongside many volcanic runoffs. The runoff has created many small valleys and will likely have lots of snow inside them. Once you hit the 3 mile mark, the grind really begins. You'll hike up many steep rock fields bordered by small valleys. As you go further up, there will be less rocks and snow will take its place. You'll hit a small weather station at about 5,000 feet elevation, which is where I strapped on my crampons and stayed on the snow for the rest of the way up. The wind will really start to kick in at above 5,000 feet and it doesn't cease. At about 1,000 feet below the summit, you'll hit a pretty steep snowfield, and ice axe and crampons are very much recommended. Once you get past this steep face, it's about a grueling quarter mile to the top. Unfortunately, I had whiteout conditions from about 6,000 feet and up. I would highly suggest only attempting to climb this peak on a day with clear skies and low wind. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below and I'd be happy to help. With that being said, let's begin the climb.
How's it going, guys? As you can see, we're getting very close to the end of the tree line. We're about a few miles in, and you know, we're getting that classic Washington state weather. It's very foggy and very overcast, but it's a beautiful day, and the snow is patchy at this point. Like I said, 2 miles in, I've probably gained about 2,000 feet of elevation, and so far I haven't had to put on my crampons, but we're getting close, and I'm excited, so let's get to it. For the moment.
I know, that's exactly.
Is that hood over there, I think?
Yeah, it's out, yeah. That's
yeah.
Hood.
That's awesome.
And a clear day, you see all the way to Jefferson, and behind that Sisters.
Yeah.
The Adams.
Yeah, over there. Over there. Yeah, then right here, yeah.
Right here, there, yeah.
I think we're halfway?
A little bit less than halfway.
Alright.
Yeah.
Great.
Probably
you guys caught up to me.
Yeah, probably. Hitting the snow from now on, I guess.
Okay, yeah.
It's good for us. Good yeah, for me. And,
Yeah. As long as, you know, once you put the crampons on, they stay on. Like, you know, it's the worst when you go from snow to rock field to snow.
Yeah, I think it's going to be snow all the way, and it looks pretty soft too as well.
Yeah.
I don't think it's that icy up there.
How's it going, guys? We just made it just above the weather station right behind me. At this point, I'm about halfway, and it is all snow all the way up, so it's a great fun time. Your jacket, and so when you stop walking, oh man, it is nasty. It really is a beautiful day out, though.
Hello.
I mean, the forecast was going to be completely cloudy, and I mean, just the fact that I can see some sky right now is pretty nice. Very nice people as well, and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling excited. If you're watching this, please come out. Please come enjoy St. Helens. Make sure you have a permit. But other than that, it's good. It's good flipping time. Up here, as you can see, so that's too interesting, but stay tuned for some questions.